Hanoi Medical University, and I'm working as the dean of the Faculty of Public Health and Preventive Medicine. But the team project, we work with not only public health but also with clinical medical doctor in our university. And luckily, we have Professor Heng is a president of our university. He's an obstetric expert. He also very interested in this project because our university this year is 115 years. So it's a very, very old. That's why the traditional teaching also play a very important in the university. And it's also not easy to change to the active training. But I can... but actually we also want to innovate the training methods to apply to our students, because in our university it's a big and the biggest medical university in Vietnam, because every year we recruit about more than 1,000 medical students undergraduate, and among them about 700 is a doctor degree 6-year training, and 400 about bachelor degree for a 4-year program. So it is not easy to apply the new teaching methodology, but we try our best to make it in the real life. Before the team coming, we apply almost a traditional method for all the kind of our students. And later on, about the decade of 19 and 2000, we have a project that supports with the PBL from Dutch government. It's called the Strengthening Capacity for Teaching and Learning in HMU and Other Medical University in Vietnam. We apply the PBL, but actually it already success with the number group of the students for Bachelor of Public Health and Preventive Medicine, because of the number of students is less than the practitioner doctor. That's why when we know about the team introduced by Teddy and Ella, we were very happy, because it not only can apply for the preventive medicine doctor but also for the general practitioner doctor. That's why we started with the adopt the pediatric case, and when we start, Ella and Teddy come to Vietnam and help us with training workshop for our teacher to know how about the virtual patient training methodology. And most of them are very happy and hope that we can make it in HMU. And after the workshop conducting by Terry and Elle, we starting with the adopted the pediatric cases, and then we implement the pediatric cases among our fifth-year student, and it was successfully as a so in the previous slide by Luke when he evaluated the student. And for the created new cases, we apply with the infectious disease, and we think that it is very important in the context of Vietnam, and it can be applied for both preventive medicine doctor and general practitioner doctor. That's why we go with the transmitted disease. And 6 cases was developed, including HIV topic, dengue fever topic, and hepatitis, tetanus, typhoid, and streptococcus suit infection. And all these cases are developed by our staff member in the faculty in the Department of Infectious Disease, and we also have a discuss with the preventive medicine doctor as well. And all the members who developed these cases already attend the workshop conducted by the pediatric expert who have been training by Terry and Ella when they was in Vietnam. And one of them already sent to St. George University is Miss Thu. Actually, she should be here to give the presentation today, but unfortunately, visa problem. That's why I have to present instead of her. And the working group consistent 8 faculty member who is an infectious disease expert in our university, and they work in the group with the support from the pediatric, the one who was well trained by Terry and Anna. They help them to develop the cases, and after they create the 6 cases, they already implement the test with our 5th-year student, general practice doctor student, and it was going very well. And we also send those cases to the expert outside the university, and also the very older expert in the department for getting the comment from them. This is the name of the doctor who developed the case. And we hope that we can implement the case around November this year in January next year. But we found some advantages and some disadvantages. I can say that the advantages is that we have a very strong support from the leader of the university, and Professor King is the one who support for it, and we have a strong bond with the other department in the university, so it is very good for us to implement the new cases. And also the faculty member also very eager and very happy to implement these cases. And the first one, I want to mention about the difficulties. Besides the lack of the equipment and the room for the tutorial, but we also have a very large number of the medical doctor students. So I wonder how can we implement in the whole university for the group of very big number of students. And the second thing is a lack of the people with experience in developing the cases to review. For example, last time when we was in Ukraine, I already mentioned about whether we should translate it into English for you to review, but it is not possible because it will cost a lot of time and also energy. But we will try our best to send the cases to other experts to have the recommendation. So that is all for my presentation. Thank you very much.